Alright, so just make sure your body's straight on that line. Just really get away from that line. Bring this leg up to 90 degrees and beyond, just like that. Take this hand out now. Just place it right here. Now that rolls the shoulder over a little bit, so sometimes it's better for your posture here. I always like for somebody to have something under their head. Okay, they don't, their neck doesn't, so just any type of pad. If the neck position is wrong, it throws off the whole stretch, so now he can relax right there. He brings this leg up. It's great if he can get right there. If he can't, come around for this side.
Let me interrupt you for a second. Look at this. Do you see it? Do you see that it's a get up?
Now, if you can grab there, that's great. Now notice, there's two ways to grip this. Palm down, which gives you what kind of posture? Now we can do it that way if you're so tight that's all you can get. But the goal is palm up, so palm up, both legs are locked down. Now the first move, that we want to let that head relax, you want another level in there?
Okay.
Okay. The first thing we want to do is put this knee back on the line or get this hip extended. Beautiful. Now, in this position, I want him to fire some of those tight muscles in his lower body, because that's what he was using over here, contract, relax. For about 10 seconds after a muscle contracts, it'll relax out a little bit better, so you get your max stretch in that 10-second window. So in this position, drive this foot toward me, drive this shin toward me, but don't let it happen. So bring your legs back together. Push, 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 relax. Now after you relax, rotate your shoulders. Let your whole body go. Keep that down. Let this leg fall. Let that leg fall. Let your shoulders go. Take a few breaths. If you can breathe right here, that's good. If you can't even breathe right here, come back out of it to take a breath. Now, it'd be great if he could turn his shoulders more. But if he just forces his shoulders back, he'll only gain a little bit. Watch this. Really try to straighten this leg out. Really try to fire that hip down. Push, push with both. Push as hard as you can with both. Relax, relax. And take up the slack. If we fire this, it relaxes this. If we say, hey, try to bring your shoulder back up to 12 o'clock. Come on, 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 relax. Pull that leg back. So we go the opposite. Getting this helps your rotation. Getting your rotation helps this. So we go back and forth. We confuse the brain just a little bit. It lets go of some of that tension that it built up incorrectly. And the number one most important thing about this stretch is, does it feel the same way on the other side? Because if it doesn't, we're going for balance first, then we go for flexibility. Left-right balance, according to most of the research that Lee and I cycled through here, causes injuries more than being tight. So I'm not so much worried about your tightness right here. The first thing I'm worried about is I'd love to see a mirror image. So let's stack the whole thing on the other side, get into start position. Top leg is up. And anything it takes to get that position, just like that, head down. Now, if you can go ahead and stretch a little bit there, stretch. Don't turn the shoulders though, stretch with the legs. So you pull this leg up. Now, fire them both, fire them both. Fire, fire, put the head down, fire them both, fire them both, fire them both, and relax, take up